Hello children, welcome to this English class. Today I am going to teach you an interesting story of your English textbook. But at first I will ask you some questions. Okay? Children, tell me, do you sometimes fight with your brothers and sisters? Yes, good. Now tell me, who do you go to settle your quarrel? To your parents? Okay, good. Now tell me, when the people fight with each other, where do they go to get the justice? Yes, they go to the court. Now tell me, who gives them the justice? Yes, the judge gives them the justice. So children, I think you all can now easily imagine what the title of the story is. Yes, very good. The title of the story is The Village Judge. Children, let's know something about the story, The Village Judge. This story is very interesting and amusing. It is written by Munshi Premchand. It consists of four parts. It is based on the theme of friendship, brotherhood among different religions, care of elderly and justice. Great power comes with great responsibility is the central point of this story. It gives us a very good lesson which we will discuss at the end of the story. Children, now collect some ideas about the writer Munshi Premchand. Munshi Premchand was born on 31st July 1880. He was died on 8 October 1936. His name was Dhanpat Rai Srivastav. He was better known by his pen name Munshi Premchand. He was an Indian writer famous for his modern Hindustani literature of the early 20th century. He has been regarded as the Upanyas Samrat. Children, as you know, the story has four parts. So, at first, listen carefully while I am reading the first para of the first part of the story. Juman Sheikh and Algu Chaudhary were great friends. Each trusted the other completely. Juman Sheikh had an old aunt. She had a small piece of property. Juman had persuaded her to transfer the property to his name. So long as it was not done, the aunt had been treated with great kindness and respect. But when the property was transferred, all kindness vanished. Juman and his wife Kariman became harsh and rude. Children, now see the second para. For some time the aunt bore all this, but when she could bear it no more, she complained to Juman, "Soon I can't go on like this anymore. You should give me some money. I shall cook and eat separately." Juman replied rudely, "Money does not grow on trees here." Children, let's discuss the meaning of some unfamiliar words of this two para. Trust, it means believe. Persuade, it means convince. Next, treat, it means behave. Vanish, it means disappear suddenly. Then harsh, it means rigid. Next, rude, it means cruel. Then gone, it's a phrasal verb which means continue. The last one is be, which means tolerate. Children, now come to the story. The story starts with introducing two characters. See the pictures. There are two characters. One is Juman Sheikh and another is Algo Chaudhary. They were great friends. That means they were very close to each other. See the pictures, how they are enjoying their friendship. Children, let's know about the theme of the first para. Juman Sheikh and Algo Chaudhary were two great friends. They were very close to each other. Each trusted the other completely. Juman Sheikh had an old aunt. She had a small piece of property. Juman Sheikh convinced his old aunt to transfer the property to his name. So long as the property was not transferred to his name, the aunt had been treated with great kindness and love. But when the property was transferred to the name of Juman Sheikh, the behavior of Juman Sheikh and his wife Kariman was completely changed. They behaved her badly. Children, let's know about the second para. For some time, the aunt tolerated all this. But when she could not tolerate it, she complained to Juman that she could not go on like that anymore. She proposed to Juman to give her some money so that she could cook and eat separately. Suddenly, Juman replied impolitely that money does not grow on trees there. Children, let's discuss some questions of this two para. Answer in a word or in a phrase. First questions, who were Juman Sheikh and Algo Chaudhary? Yes, they were great friends. Next question, who had a small piece of property? Very good, the old aunt. The next one is, what did Juman persuade his old aunt? Yes, to transfer the property to his name. Children, the next question is, what did the old aunt ask for? Very good, some money. Now, the last one is, why did the old aunt ask for some money? Very good, to cook and eat separately. Children, let's answer some more questions. Number 2, fill in the blanks. Question number A. The story The Villagers was written by Das. Very good, Prem Chand. Question number B. Juman Sheikh had an Das. Correct, old aunt. Question number C. The old aunt had a das. Good. Small piece of property. Next question is, Juman persuaded her to transfer the das to his name. Very good. Property. Children, your last question is, das does not grow on trees here. Zuman replied, "Very good, money." Children, today we discussed the two paras of this story. The rest part of the story we'll discuss in the next classes. Okay? Thank you. Bye-bye.